If you want a good time, if you want a good time, let me hear you say,
hey, everybody say, hey.
Remember, remember the 5th of November, gunpowder, treason, and plot. I see no reason why gunpowder treason should ever be forgot. Welcome to Guy Fawkes Day. Welcome to November the 5th. And welcome to the election.
Know how you can vote.
We can't answer the door right now, but if you'd like to leave a message, you can do it now.
Shameful. Are you the one that walks by here and always screaming at people?
No, I haven't walked by recently.
Okay, because a lot of people walk by and scream.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. You are voting for the devil. Don't you know that?
No.
Why are you voting for him?
Because I believe he is the moral candidate.
Oh my God. F*** you for that one.
That's
moral?
Exactly right. That's how your side acts.
Oh, my God. He's the most immoral person around.
In your opinion, that's okay.
Oh,
f***. I'm sorry. Have a nice day.
Fuck you.
Have a nice day.
We've all been waiting for this, and it's time to do your best Kamala Harris.
Kamala did what Kamala always does. She just put her head down, and she went to work.
That's right. You just got to get in there, put your head down. So, giving a quick look at yesterday. Yesterday looked, if you look at the stats board, 57.25 on the open, 57.41 on the highs, below 5,700 for the first time since that October 7th gap was created that we filled. Closed at 57.1269. Down 3 points on the open, 45-point range, closed below the open, closed below Friday's close. All looks pretty blasé. But then you come over to the spread room and, 43%. It ain't, you know, triple digits, but it was safe. 5670, 5695, 5700 bullish puts. Not triple digits, but it worked. Full credit. And then you had that end of the day where, you know, going through yesterday, started out at 4:30 in the morning, a little bit earlier than where I am now because I cannot sleep getting ready for this. So here we are, 5750, 5745 calls, the low risk trade, getting $1.50 or better. As long as SPX is above 5723, we owe it respect that 5770 plus or minus 5 can show. 9:30 was game on. Needed that 57.23. The Russell, we made a few comments about that. Russell. Russell closed below 22.22. Good money over there on the Russell, which obviously quite a few people took advantage of. And as we come down here, there you go with Rick. You know, Rockstar teed off 12:30, already out of his trade. Bang, bang, bang on the 57.50, 57.45s. As we come down, the reason why I am wasting your time on this is on the 1 o'clock mention about the multiple failure pivots that we were at. 5725, 22141, 487, and 419, and the VIX being at 2217. My opinion, I honestly like a low 5700, high 5600 close. And the risk, 5720 close, closing below that. And yeah, I did not ask permission if I could share the message. Thus, I have blacked out the name and the image so that he cannot be tracked. 5720 call spread at $2 just made $5,000. This is the way. 50 contracts. Yeah, it is the way. And as you saw with a couple of other people over there in the alert room, I'll get over this in a minute. The $1.50 for 0DTE 5705 puts if you're bored. Well, those really didn't work, did they? They had a chance right there from $1.50, and you grinded down. You had a little pop over here at 230, and then you had your pop at 235. But, I mean, you essentially had about a three-minute window in order to get out with a tiny bit of profit. But as we were showing there a couple of seconds ago, because, again, Nancy, she not only spent time next to me, but she understands and has taken this to a completely new level as to where she was when we first met. 5725 puts it 4.25, because why would you buy three 5705s when you can buy one 5725 or 10, 3, 20, 5, however it works out with whatever your size is. 4.25, she got them in. And where did those go? Two o'clock. You had your pop up here above 15, and you closed out the end of the day a little bit greater than 11. So this is the reason why, after years of banging her head the wrong way, she had a good day. Everybody deserves credit when they have good days, and everybody deserves to keep themselves into their own camp. If you don't even have a $100,000 trading account, don't think that you're going to make $100,000 in a trading account. Work your way up to it. Everything works in its own speed, and I will work with every one of you, as you all know, who have done one-on-one calls with me. So anyway, enough with that. Today is election day, okay? The election is tonight. The results are expected to be in tonight.
Just go out and vote for Kamala, even if she is retarded. Okay, we already got Joe out of the way. Just vote for Kamala so we can win this thing and we'll figure it out. Okay?
Plus 1%, 5769.82. Minus 1%, coincidentally, being 5655.56. Now, again, this is a science with a little bit of art. It's not an art with a little bit of science. And I'll get over that in a second, but looking over here at the QQQ, how you came down right to that 484. You've been coming down here 3 days in a row. I'll show you why that matters in a minute. No plus 1%, no minus 1% as yesterday went, and we closed below the plus 20% year-to-date level, which is 487. Over on the Russell 2000, the IWM, plus 1%, and then, boop, right on back down below that big pivot, that 221.41. Green day on Friday, two green days in a row, and as I mentioned before, if Trump wins,
it will be not a game changer, because that's not a nice enough term. It will be wonderful. It'll be so beautiful. It'll be a gift from heaven if it works.
This is the big, big, big winner, is the Russell 2000. So taking on to the charts. That's not the charts that you want to be looking at. You want to be looking at this one. Here we go. So here we are again, looking at a 15-day view, just so you can see where we've come from, and we will zoom that out into a 30-day view. This gap is filled. This gap is filled. This gap being down here at 56.95.91, we missed it by a fraction of a couple of pennies, but we can remove that gap. That gap comes from way back here, all the way on October 7th. The gap below is a gap that we have not been able to break into since the middle portion of September. That's your post-FOMC gap, right over here with 56.74 being the October lows. As you can see from anybody's naked eye chart pattern, we are pushing for it. We are trying to get to it, which is the reason why I gave you the trade I gave you on Friday, which is actually up a little bit, not as much as it was yesterday, but it is up. Looking for that break down below this 56.94 and pressing into that 56.60 region. 56.60, 56.50, down in there with this gap being way, way down at 56.20. It's asking a little bit too much, but, you know, we'll go with it. Over here on the VIX, which I will get to at the end of this, and it's very important that you follow with that. Here on the VIX, not seeing the conviction that we'd like to see with this 2217 now being broken, having a little bit of a downside move as of we are here early this morning, 3:45. Over here on the QQQ, yet again, hanging in this green region, this 487, 483 area, with the gap down below, taking us down below that, all the way to 482, with a much, much larger gap, well below that, below 477, which fills down at 471. NVIDIA, very possibly, because there's a lot of problems happening because of SMCI and their accounting fraud, a lot. Come over onto the IWM, and I really don't care who you are or what kind of eyes you have. This is a massive region here. A little bit above 215, right over there, right around this here, this 217.50 area, and then 221.41 being your breakpoint with everything failing as it breaks above 221.41. But Trump could win. He could win. Trump wins. This thing's going to 230, end of the year. And then you come over here to your Dow Jones. Your Dow Jones, which took a lot of the work that was being done on the S&P all through August, September, and October. And here we are grinding down into this big 417 region where, when you do zoom out, yes, you are looking at new 30-day lows, but you've still got a plethora of downside. And a break below that 416.68 is just as significant as the SPX breaking down below 56.70. So very closely monitoring a break over here on 416, 417, with 411 being down below, 407 needing to hold everything together. Because any kind of a break below 400, the gloves are off, game on. So bring it back again to the SPX, looking at this from the bullish perspective and the bullish view, which again, we have no reason to say it is not until it has proven that it is not. And that proving is your gray zone here. As we said, looking for something in that 5675, 5630 region, and a very strong hold and a strong support on that, not breaking down, and we can still at least keep the bullish view alive. That's what we're looking at. 5769 as of now, roughly where your major resistance is going to continue to be until after there's a winner decided on tonight's election. Bear view, bearish view, very much so. Looking at that 5678, 5634. Any kind of breakdown below that 5634, and we start to open up the gates that go down into that low 5400 region. We don't have any answers yet, because the election is tonight, and I was wrong. I thought the FOMC was tomorrow. The FOMC is on Thursday. Thank you for correcting me, because I would have thought that the FOMC was going to be on Wednesday. Here with the new moons, nothing to really go out here and say this is scientific. This is artistic is what it is. And expecting that the full moon placement, or I'm sorry, the new moon placement falls in line roughly with that move down to 5675, 5630, I'll just bring you in here to note showing you how, like back here in June, the new moon didn't work. Back over here in May, new moon didn't work. Back over here in, call it, well, that one not so much, but yeah, over here in April, new moon, didn't work. Not as good as the full moon, but it's still, it has such a decent track record that we're giving it a little bit of respect here. And with that respect, that means that we should continue to look at this from a bullish point of view. The bullish view being that we are in the much needed cool down, even though we can't even use the word dip anymore. A cool down. The cool down since that low over here in August, since the low over here in September. Cool down meaning that we should see 56.75, 56.30. And again, assuming that we get a win, which is Donald Trump announced tonight, the move should push back up into the 5800s very, very quickly, if not immediately. A break above that 58.62, everything up here in the 6000 region starts to become reality going into the end of the year, beginning of Q1 of next year, for the end of the fifth wave. Fifth wave of the fifth wave that everybody's been trying to catch the top of. So, on that note, I bring you on to the VIX. I don't know how many of you are still here. Well, that's not going to work, so I'll just bring you back to mid-August. Bear with me a second. 08, and we will go with, let's go with 10, just so we can get the yen carry forward trade sell-off off of the window. And there you go. So looking back here, just about going back to mid-August, early August, after the yen carry forward blow-off, and as you saw, that big spike was up there in the 50-60s, and here was your sell-off going into the middle of the month of August, down here to 14. Here were your lows going out to my birthday, the end of September, down here in the 15 region. We have not broken down below 18 for basically the entire month of October. The entire month of October going into the election, we've been holding this 18 region. Now, how many of you were with us in 2016 when we traded Brexit? I know it's only a few of you, but when we traded Brexit, and we were right, we were not in SPY puts. We were not in SPX puts because they were too expensive. But instead, what we did was we played the VIX calls. And the VIX calls, back then, you had your big spike because of the drop, because of Brexit, and we made somewhere in the region of 500, 600% on those VIX calls. Well, something to consider. VIX calls. Or, I apologize. VIX puts on a Trump win. November 6th expiration, being Wednesday, I wouldn't touch. And as you can see over here, looking at the right column, there's no volume. Looking at November 13th, again, same thing, I wouldn't touch them. There's simply no volume. However, looking over here to November 20th, which is OPEX, there's a considerable amount of volume that is out here in the 17, 18 region, 18 being the big line to be broken down below. Below 18, you get into the 15s. And let me just move this a little bit. Looking here at the November 20th 15 puts, 396,000 open interest over here, 325,000 on the 16s. Me? I would stick up here in the 19 and 18 is where I would be. I'll put that in your email, but that's where, if I was going to be betting that tonight there is a decision, and tonight that decision is Donald Trump wins, this would be a trade that I would have on the table here. Would be the November 20th VIX 19 or even 18 puts for November 20th. Knowing, once again, I don't know why my tonality is what it is, but again, knowing that that break below 1811, you immediately start looking at 1622 with the 15s and 14s down below that region. The 15s and 14s, in my opinion, would be a little bit too much risk, even though that is where you land. You land in the 15s, you hit down into the 14s. The 18 break, that's a little bit more my style. So I'll have that over there with you. And again, with it being the elections tonight, you don't need to take any of this stuff personal. Everybody's sick of it. Nobody wants either one of them to be around there. But if she does win,
good evening, London. Allow me first to apologize for this
emergency channel.
I do, like many of you, appreciate the comforts of the everyday routine, the security of the familiar, the tranquility of repetition.
Bloody hell.
I enjoy them as much as any bloke. But in the spirit of commemoration,
whereby
those important events of the past, usually associated with someone's death or the end of some awful bloody struggle, are celebrated with a nice holiday, I thought we could mark this November the 5th, a day that is sadly no longer remembered, by taking some time out of our daily lives to sit down and have a little chat. There are, of course, those who do not want us to speak.
Let me think, just let me think.
I suspect even now, orders are being shouted into telephones, and men with guns will soon be on their way.
It's Chancellor Sutler.
Damn it!
Why? Because while the truncheon may be used in lieu of conversation, words will always retain their power. Words offer the means to meaning, and for those who will listen, the enunciation of truth. And the truth is, there is something terribly wrong with this country, isn't there?
You designed it, sir. You wanted it foolproof. You told me every television in London.
Cruelty and injustice, intolerance and oppression. And where once you had the freedom to object, to think and speak as you saw fit, you now have sensors and systems of surveillance coercing your conformity and soliciting your submission.
We need cameras.
How did this happen? Who's to blame? Well, certainly there are those who are more responsible than others, and they will be held accountable. But again, truth be told, if you're looking for the guilty, you need only look into a mirror. I know why you did it. I know you were afraid. Who wouldn't be? War, terror, disease. There were a myriad of problems which conspired to corrupt your reason and rob you of your common sense. Fear got the best of you, and in your panic you turned to the now High Chancellor, Adam Sutler. He promised you order, he promised you peace, and all he demanded in return was your silent, obedient consent.
Inspector, you're almost through.
Last night I sought to end that silence. Last night I destroyed the Old Bailey to remind this country of what it has forgotten. More than 400 years ago, a great citizen wished to embed the 5th of November forever in our memory. His hope was to remind the world that fairness, justice, and freedom are more than words. They are perspectives. So if you've seen nothing, if the crimes of this government remain unknown to you, then I would suggest that you allow the 5th of November to pass unmarked. But if you see what I see, if you feel as I feel, and if you would seek as I seek, then I ask you to stand beside me one year from tonight, outside the gates of Parliament, and together we shall give them a 5th of November that shall never, ever be forgotten.